Hello everyone. Today I'm making a presentation of our EL6509 wireless communication course. And my topic is channel estimation in OFDM system. My name is Ruo Chenxu and my UF ID is 3919-9233. The presentation has six main parts. The first one is the motivation, the second one is experimental measures, and the third one is simulation parameters, and the fourth one I made a block diagram for the whole channel, and the fifth one is the result and analysis, and the sixth one is the further work I'm interested in. Let's go to the first part, motivation. The first question is, what is OFDM? OFDM is an orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, which is with some multiple subcarriers, so it's a special case of a multi-carrier modulation. OFDM transmits several data in parallel through multiple orthogonal subcarriers, which can increase the symbol width, reduce the frequency bands occupied by a single symbol, and resist the frequency selective fading caused by multiphase. The history of OFDM is long. It was firstly introduced by Chen of Bell's Labs in 1966. OFDM was improved by Winston and Evers in 1961 by introducing the Gata interval. A couple of years later, the Sickening prefix is introduced to solve the problems of orthogonal between subcarriers and in a dispersive channel. In recent few years, LTE is greatly used in our daily lives. It is greatly different from the old measures like the GSM and UMTS. As the GSM only has 9.6 kilobits per second as its data rate, and the UMTS is much better, it's increasing to 21 megabits per second, but LTE has over 100 megabits per second. OFDM is one of the core technology of LTE. So you can think OFDM is the core technology of fourth generation communication.
So why we are just using OFDM rather than other methods? There is a comparison between OFDM and FDM. Let me introduce FDM first. FDM divides the available bandwidth into many subcarriers and allows multiple users to access the system simultaneously. Different users' data transmits on different subcarriers. Between subcarriers, there was a gap band to avoid interference. In multiple users' FDM, the data of the user can be split into multiple substrings and transmit them in parallel to make the data rate higher. Well, in OFDM, the subcarriers are designed to be orthogonal. This allows the subcarriers to overlap and save bandwidth, thus achieving higher data rates.
Let me introduce some advantages of OFDM technology. The first one is OFDM technology can continuously monitor sudden changes in communication characteristic on the transmission. Since the ability of a communication path to transmit data changes over time, OFDM can dynamically adapt to it and turn on and off the corresponding carriers. The technology can automatically detect which specific carriers on the transmission medium has a high signal attenuation or interference pulse, and then take appropriate modulation measure to enable the carrier a specified frequency to successfully communicate. Moreover, the biggest advantage of OFDM technology is to resist the frequency selective fading or narrowband interference. In a single carrier system, a single fading or interference can cause the entire communication link to fail. But in a multi-carrier system, only a small part of carrier will be interfered. Error correction code can also be used for error correction on these subchannels. OFDM technology is particularly suitable for use in high-rise buildings, densely populated in geographic prominent areas and areas where the signal is spread. High-speed data transmission and digital voice broadcasting are expected to reduce the effect of multiplex effects on signals. Due to the existence of multiple orthogonal subcarriers in an OFDM system and its output signal is a superposition of multiple subchannels, compared with a single carrier, it has the following disadvantage. The first one is it is susceptible to frequency deviation. The second one is there is a high speed peak to average power ratio. After I introduced the introduction of OFDM system, I have a couple of questions about OFDM, like how to build a channel, how to make the channel estimation, and what is the bit error rates. Well, that's the second part, experimental methods. Firstly, let me talk about the basic idea of OFDM. The basic idea of OFDM is to decompose a high-rate data stream into many low-rate subdata streams and transmit them in multiple strings in parallel. The strings maintain the minutely orthogonal relationship with each other to eliminate the string's data interference, and each subcarrier can be regarded as an independent subchannel. The typical form of data transmission in a serial data stream, the symbols are transmitted continuously and the spectrum of each data symbol can occupy the entire available bandwidth. However, in a parallel data transmission system, many symbols are transmitted at the same time, which reduces the problems that occur in serial system. In an OFDM system, the rate of each transmission symbol is between tens of bits per second to tens of kilobits per second. So serial conversion must be performed to convert the input serial bit stream into OFDM parallel symbols that can be transmitted. Most signal processing uses DFT. DFT is a form of transformation in which previous signals are sampled in both time and frequency domain. Fast Fourier transform is only a fast mathematical method for computing application. Due to its high efficiency, OFDM technology has developed robustly. In order to eliminate inter-symbol interference to the greatest extent, a guard interval can also be inserted between each OFDM symbol, and the length of guard interval is generally larger than the maximal experimental extension in the wireless channel, so that the multi-phase component of the symbol will not be aligned. One more important thing is the modulation and demodulation methods. For OFDM system, QAM and PSA is greatly used, and in this project, I'm using QAM modulation. Channel estimation is the process of estimating the model parameters of a certain channel model from received data. Through the channel estimation algorithm, the receiver can get an impulse response of the channel. An adaptive channel equalizer uses a channel estimation to counteract the effect of ISI. Well, let's move to the third part, the simulation parameters. In this project, my main method is using the variable SNR to obtain the different result of the bit error rates from two channel estimation methods. One is LS, one is DFT. And I set the carrier counts to be 64 and set the number of symbols to be 50. And I set the signal prefix length is 16, it's 8, and the pilot interval is 8, and the loop number 6 is 15. And these two initialized metrics is to count the number of error bits. Well, now is the fourth part. Block diagram. I have drawn a block diagram by myself for the OFDM system. but my block diagram is for the paper, so it cannot be shown well in the PowerPoint presentation. So I find a block diagram from the internet, which is sent to myself, and I will show it first. The diagram starts with input data, and after that, it goes through the channel coding and modulation. In my project, I'm using QAM. And then insert guard band. After that, using a serial to parallel operation to get multipass and make inverse discrete Fourier transform to get time domain, then make parallel to serial and cyclic prefix insertion and make a digital to analog transform, then go past a fading channel like relay and analog to digital transform, then delete the cyclic prefix and make the serial to parallel, go to the DFT again and again to the parallel to serial. Finally, delete the guard band and the channel decode and channel demodulation to get output data. Before showing the final result, I'm gonna to make a demo of my project. Please take a couple of time. Well, I got the bit error rates of LS and DFT channel estimation of OFDM systems, and I will show it in result. The general trend of two algorithms is the same, and as the SNR ratio increased, the bit error rates continue to decrease. At the same time, it can be seen from the figure that the SNR ratio, when SNR is more, the channel estimation of LS algorithm has larger error and DFT is much better, and when the SNR is large enough, like to 25 dB, the bit error rate meets a constant close to zero. You can make a conclusion that the IFFT and FFT can effectively and simply achieve multi-carrier modulations of OFDM signal, and the use of QAM modulation can transmit multi-based data at the same time. OFDM can effectively improve the bandwidth efficiency. And when the SNR is about to 25, the bit error rate is close to zero and indicates that it has a good performance of transmission property of OFDM system. Well, let's move to the first work of the MIMO OFDM. MIMO means the multiple input and multiple output. It has high diversity gain and a high multi-complexity gain. It combined with the OFDM advantage, the bandwidth efficient and robust multi-phase fading thanks to cyclic prefix, and easy to implement because it's using IFFT and FFT, and it's flexible to resource allocation, so it's greatly used in the fourth generation mobile communication. Another first work in this area is the higher quality of the modulation methods like the 1024 QAM. It makes more carriers, make the speeds much faster, and it is the core technology of the 802.11ax, the new Wi-Fi. And the last part is the reference I'm used in my paper. Thanks for watching my presentation and thanks for the course.